You can't imagine how inconvenient travel. Protego! Accio! Incendio! 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 Protego! Incendio! Incendio! Protego! Incendio! Incendio! Thank you. Incendio! Potato! Stupefy! Incendio! Yes! Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included. Revelio. Incendio! Revelio.
Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Could you remind me how the Dedalian keys work again?
When you spot or hear a flying key, you're to follow it back to its cabinet. Inserting it in the lock is the tricky part. I hope you follow some. If you open a cabinet, I'd love to know what you find, if anything.
I hope you're able to take care of...
Professor, I completed all of your most recent assignments.
Well done. Then you're ready to learn Expelliarmus. Pay close attention. The disarming charm may often be all you need to defeat the most powerful dark witches and wizards you might encounter. Spellcasting requires... Good work. The dummy is here if you wish to stay in practice.
Professor, do you have a moment?
I do. What is it?
I wondered, did you attend Hogwarts?
I did. I am a proud member of Ravenclaw House. Why do you ask?
I was curious as to how Hogwarts has changed over the years.
I see. Well, the castle itself, as I'm sure you have surmised, is full of surprises. I dare say more than the staircases change around here. As for the students, well, they seem to get more capable every year. Although, we got up to just as much mischief in my day as you seem to now. I used to look the other way at all sorts of roguery when I was head girl. I can tell you, however, that I did once admonish a certain Phineas Nigellus Black for enjoying a sugar quill during a lecture.
I hadn't realized that you and Professor Black were, students here together.
Appearances can be deceiving. You see, I was once wounded by time itself.
Time itself? I never would have imagined such a thing.
Ah, well, it was the risk I took with my prior position. You may or may not have heard that I was an unspeakable at the Ministry for years.
An unspeakable? What does...
As you might suspect, I cannot speak about what we did. Suffice it to say, the job was not without its hazards. I hope I've satisfied your curiosity for the moment.
You have. Thank you for speaking with me, Professor.
Keep up with your wand work. One must always be prepared for mischief, both inside and outside of the castle.
Expelliarmus!
You seem to have the right end of the stick, but keep practicing. Expelliarmus may save your life one day.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Revelio.
You idiot! Lolly has served our family for 5 generations, and you go and give her clothes!
Revelio.
What are you up to now?
You there! Yes, you! I wonder if you might come with me for a moment.
It's me, Gareth. Do you have a moment?
You wanted to see me, sir?
Yes! Sir Nicholas de Mimsey Porpington, at your service.
Nice to meet you, Sir Nicholas.
I know about the book. You were spotted with Mr. Sallow in the restricted section. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
Thank you.
it up with those pages. If you'd be so kind as to perform a small favor for me along the way.
Small favor in exchange for getting those pages.
Yes, it's nothing really. I'd be grateful if you could simply go into the kitchen and procure a little rotten roast beef.
I beg your pardon? Roast beef?
Rotten roast beef. If one floats through it just right, Revenue. One can almost taste it.
Ah, well, I suppose I can do that.
Now, if you'd be so kind as to collect the roast beef, I shall explain everything else in due course.
Revelio.
Ah, here we are. Tickle the pear and head on in.
Did you?
Yes, in the painting. I'll wait right here. Do try not to get in the way of the house elves. I'm already imagining the sweet aroma of rotten roast beef.
A student.
Can think he get for you a pumpkin pasty? You didn't eh? Please help yourself. Think he supposes Nick's tired of loitering about simply to experience the faintest memory of the taste of food.
Do you and the other house elves conjure the food served in the Great Hall?
Goodness, no! Not even house elves can conjure food out of thin air! Food is one of the five principal exceptions to Gamp's law of elemental transfiguration. We can, however, multiply it, transform it, and of course, prepare it! Then we send it straight up to the Great Hall.
Is it all right for students?
Well, since you asked, students aren't supposed to be in the kitchens, but Finky doesn't mind. There's nothing that lifts Finky's spirits more than the company of students. We so rarely get visitors, and we have plenty of treats. Come back anytime you please.
It was nice to meet you. Thank you for the beef.
Happy to help, and to meet you as well. Please give Nick Finky's regards.
Revelio.
It's nothing like a meal prepared by a house elf.
Revelio.
Lucille's in line here in the kitchen. It's all right. She's the kind-hearted sort.
Ah, you're back. I take it?
Not at all. Finky sends her regards, along with the rotten roast beef.
Ah, glad. You'll see. Anyway, I don't know how, but a member of that Richard Jackdaw had the pages when he was alive. Another matter I wish to discuss.